Zapier is an online automation platform, allowing you to connect your favorite apps and services so you can automate your workflow and save time. Here, I've created an extremely simple scheduling form. When somebody submits my form, I want to create a new meeting within my Zoom account while simultaneously populate my Pipedrive CRM. Before connecting your platforms or services with Zapier, you will want to ensure that you run a test submission on your form. This is so Zapier has some real data to test a connection with. From our editor, we'll click After Submission, Integrations and Webhooks. We'll scroll down and select Zapier. In the search bar, I'm then going to search for Zoom. Then I'll click the Zoom app. This is going to prompt you to log into your Zapier account or even create a new Zapier account. We'll need to ensure we change Create Webinar Registrant to Create Meeting. We can see that the trigger of our Zapier is currently a new form submission, while the action is to create a meeting within Zoom. Now let's build this combination. Click the button and then select Get Started. It's time to begin building our Zap. First and foremost, we'll need to connect our Paperform account. Click Connect and then select Authorize. We'll then want to click the Next button and select our correlating form. Zapier will now get the data from our test submission. Now, let's connect our Zoom account. Again, click Connect. And again, click Authorize. Now click Next. We want to select Meeting as we are creating a new meeting. Click Next, and now let's customize our meeting. In the topic field, I'm going to type My Meeting With, and then use the process of answer piping to display the answer my submitter gives to my name question. For the When field, I'm going to search for the start date, click the icon, input a spacebar, and then click the start time. For the duration, I'm simply going to input 30 to represent 30 minutes. I'll then click Next and select my correlating time zone. Click Next, and now it's time to test this Zap. Zapier is going to use our last test submission to run a test of this connection. And voila, we can see that the test has been successful. If we jump into our Zoom account, we can see that a new meeting has been created. My meeting with Billy Bob. Perfect. Jumping back into Zapier, we'll click Next again, and it's time to turn on our Zap. We'll click Turn On, and we can see that our Zap has been successfully created. Now, every time a new person submits the form, a meeting will be created in our Zoom account. To edit the configuration of your Zap, just simply click the Manage Your Zap. All right, now let's take a look at connecting our Pipedrive CRM to our Paperform. Let's click Create Zap and search for Paperform. We'll click Paperform and then select our trigger event, being a new form submission. Hit that Continue button and select your Paperform account. Once selecting, we'll click Continue, and then we'll be prompted to select which form we want to set up our Zap connection on. For me, it's my scheduling form, and then I'll click Continue. Let's run a test trigger. Zapier once again is going to take a look to see if Paperform has some real data to test the connection with. Now it's time to connect our Pipedrive. Much like we searched for Paperform, we'll search for Pipedrive and click the Pipedrive app. Now let's select our action event. We want to populate our Pipedrive CRM with a new person, so we're going to select to create a person. Once doing so, we'll hit that Continue button again, and then we'll be prompted to sign in to our Pipedrive account. Click Allow and Install, and this will connect your Pipedrive to your Zapier. Once connected, simply click Continue. Now it's time to customize our Zap. For the name of our new person, I'm going to follow that process once again of answer piping and display their response to my name question. I'm going to leave the owner and organization fields blank. And for the email field, you guessed it, once again, I'm going to use that process of answer piping and display their response to my email address question. Then I'll click continue. Now, we'll just need to test that Zap. And voila, if we jump into our Pipedrive account, we can see that a new person has been created successfully. Now all we need to do is ensure we turn on our Zap. Automating your workflow is that easy. My form has now been connected to my Zoom account and my Pipedrive CRM. When someone submits my form and schedules a time, my Zoom account will automatically create a meeting. Likewise, my Pipedrive CRM will automatically create a person. If this video has been helpful, make sure to check out and subscribe to our channel, as we're constantly releasing helpful videos like this. And if you'd like to learn how to automate any other workflow, be sure to drop a comment below. Good luck and happy form making.